Today, we're diving into Greenland's remarkable economic and strategic significance using game theory and economics. Along the way, we'll introduce key concepts and definitions to help you understand these ideas better. Let's get started. First, let's talk about economic value. It's packed with valuable resources like rare earth minerals, oil, and gas. Natural resources are considered factors of production, one of the inputs required to produce goods and services. According to the European Commission, 25 of the 34 critical raw materials Europe relies on are found in Greenland. These minerals power things like electric vehicles, wind turbines, and smartphones, making Greenland a goldmine for the future economy. So, not acquiring Greenland has its opportunity costs. However, resource extraction can create negative externalities, costs incurred by third parties, or the environment that aren't reflected in the market price of the extracted resources. Balancing economic benefits with sustainability is an important consideration. But it's not just resources. Greenland is strategically located. As Arctic ice melts, new shipping routes open up, cutting travel times and costs between major economies. It also holds geopolitical value in countering Russian and Chinese ambitions in the Arctic. Now, let's use game theory, a branch of mathematics and economics, to analyze how different players interact and make decisions. Here are the players. Greenland, facing a choice between maintaining current ties, pursuing independence, or forming new agreements. Denmark, aiming to maintain stability while respecting Greenland's autonomy. The US, looking for strategic and economic advantages. In game theory, these players have distinct strategies, choices they can make to achieve their goals, and payoffs, the outcomes of those strategies. The interaction of their decisions determines the overall outcome. Each player's payoff depends on their decisions and those of others. US payoffs, high payoff, acquiring Greenland through a mutually agreeable purchase that strengthens its strategic position and access to resources. Low payoff, coercive tactics, threats of force that damage its international reputation and alliances. Neutral payoff, Greenland remains under Danish control but continues to host American bases. Denmark's payoffs, high payoff, preserving territorial integrity or facilitating Greenland's self-determination in a way that maintains goodwill and financial benefits. Low payoff, being coerced into relinquishing Greenland, leading to domestic and international backlash. Neutral payoff, Greenland retains the status quo under Denmark's sovereignty. Greenland's payoffs, high payoff, economic independence and growth, whether through selling resources, independence, or a fair deal with the US. Low payoff, exploitation, corruption, or governance failures after independence or a forced sale to the US. Neutral payoff, remaining under Danish sovereignty with steady financial support. Let's explore three possible scenarios given the payoffs and other information. Scenario one, cooperative game. The US negotiates with Denmark and Greenland, offering benefits like infrastructure investment, financial security, and guarantees of self-determination. This is a win-win strategy where all players achieve mutually beneficial outcomes. Scenario two, non-cooperative game. Coercion or pressure from one player leads to resistance and backlash from others. This scenario results in a lose-lose outcome where all players end up worse off. The third scenario could be that no one makes a move and everything remains as it is, but this will have opportunity cost. From this explanation, cooperation looks like the best response for all and could be the Nash Equilibrium. What is Nash Equilibrium? Nash Equilibrium is a concept in game theory where all the players are playing their best response to the action of other players, and no player have any incentive to change their action. And of course, best response is action that gives maximum payoff. From an economist's perspective, the potential purchase of Greenland involves weighing costs, benefits, and externalities. Costs. Financial cost of purchasing Greenland, which could range from $50 billion to hundreds of billions, depending on negotiations. Additional investment needed to develop infrastructure, exploit resources, and integrate Greenland into the US economy. Benefits: access to vast untapped resources, including rare earth minerals and hydrocarbons. Strategic military advantages in the Arctic region. Economic gains from potential resource extraction, tourism, and trade. In summary, game theory and economics provide powerful tools to analyze scenarios like this. Concepts such as payoffs, strategies, opportunity costs, and externalities help us understand the complex dynamics at play. What do you think? Share your thoughts below. And if you enjoyed this breakdown, like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more educational content. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.